Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be sharing a recipe for oxtail pepper soup, which is highly requested. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that oxtail is one of my absolute favorite cuts of meat. I use it in almost everything. When it's properly cooked, it's just super tasty and absolutely fantastic in soups, stews, and everything. But today I'll be sharing a recipe for oxtail pepper soup. Please stay and keep watching if you'd like to see how I do this. For this pepper soup, I'm going to use some oxtail, which has been cut and cleaned already. And I made sure they cut in small pieces because, as you know, oxtail takes a really long time to cook. So the smaller the pieces, the quicker they will cook. So I've washed and dried this one a little bit, and I'll tell you why in a minute. So I'm using some oxtail, some yellow and red pepper, some garlic, some tatashe, some scent leaf, some chopped onions, stock cubes, pepper soup spice, and some salt. So the first thing I like to do when I'm making my oxtail is I like to season the pieces of meat and sear it first. This seals in the flavor when I start to cook the meat with water. So I'm just going to add a little salt and stock cubes. Even though I didn't mention it before, I'm going to use a little bit of oil to sear the oxtail. So I'll just add a little to the pan. Now that the oil is hot, I'm going to add the oxtail. You don't want to overcrowd the frying pan. Your aim here is to brown the oxtail. This seals in that seasoning that you put in the meat in the beginning. And of course, it doesn't have to be just salt and stock cubes. You can use ginger, garlic powder, whatever you like. My oil is on the sides. That's why I've arranged my meat this way and nothing in the middle. You want to use medium-high heat for this because you're not trying to cook the meat. You're just trying to brown it a little bit to seal in all of the seasoning. It's starting to brown now, so I'll just flip it. This may seem like a really long process, but it's the best way to get really tasty oxtail, either for soups or for stew. If you sear it first, it's just great, and you'll see what I mean when the pepper soup is ready. So this is how I'm going to sear all of the pieces of meat before I start my pepper soup process. Like I said, you need a lot of patience to eat oxtail. That's probably why a lot of people don't cook it, because it takes a really long time to cook. But of course, it's always worth the effort, at least for me. So I take my time, and it's really on special occasions, actually maybe not special occasions, but I have to have the time and really feel like it before I go into it, because it takes a really long time. And you can prepare ahead so that you're not wasting time on the day that you actually need it. Now all my meat is browned. While this was browning, I blended the peppers and the garlic and a little bit of onions in there. So what I'll do now is I'm going to transfer the meat into a pressure cooker. It's advisable to use a pressure cooker because that will cut your cooking time down. So I'm just going to transfer this here. I'm going to add the blended peppers and garlic. Some seasoning cubes and a little salt. Also the chopped onions, a lot of onions, and some water I'll cover this now and let it cook. This may take an hour or maybe more, but I'll keep checking on it until it's soft. You guys, this oxtail has been cooking for 2 hours, no jokes. The kind of patience that it requires to eat oxtail is just untrue, but it's always worth it. So this has been cooking for 2 hours. I've transferred it from the pressure cooker. When I found it was soft, I transferred it from pressure cooker into this one so that I can finish up cooking here. Next, I'm going to add some pepper soup spice. This will be according to your taste. You can add a little at a time and then taste it and see if the flavor is deep enough or if you want to add a little bit more. Also, while the oxtail was cooking, I had to check it a couple of times and add more water and more seasoning to it. Next, I'll add the scent leaf, which I've already washed and sliced. I'm going to leave this for another 5 minutes for the leaf to cook and for the flavors to infuse. And then my oxtail pepper soup is ready. You can see that the meat is almost falling off the bone. There you have it, guys. This is my oxtail pepper soup. Super delicious, very tender oxtail. You just have to have patience when you're making oxtail, either for soups or for stews or for pepper soup even. It takes a really long time to cook, but it's absolutely worth it. I hope you try out this recipe and let me know what you think. Leave me your comments and your suggestions down below and I'll respond to them. And subscribe to my channel, please, if you haven't already done that. I'll see you in my next video. Thank you guys for watching. Bye-bye.